Do you want to get rid of jump cuts in your video? You know, those cuts where you edit out a pause, a mistake, or when you forgot your lines. Or you said, but you didn't move the camera. Sometimes, that may be the look you're going for. Like if you're a really frenetic vlogger, like Grace Helbig. But most people, they want to avoid them. Today on Subscriber Nation, I'll share with you the 30% rule, which will avoid those jump cuts and make your videos look more professional. The 30% rule is simple. If you want to avoid jump cuts, you've got to change your framing by at least 30% with every cut. The easiest way to do this is to shoot 1080p, so kind of 1920 pixels across by 1080 high. This is a setting inside your camera. Most cameras have that setting. But when you edit at 720p, which is 1280 across by 720 high. This allows you to zoom around the frame while you're editing and pick different parts so you avoid the jump cuts. Now, if you're wondering why you have to hit 30% or, you know, maybe 29%, I want to show you quickly what a less than 30% cut looks like. Did you see that? It just didn't move. It didn't change enough between frames. So I'm gonna hop over to ScreenFlow here and show you how I edit this. I love ScreenFlow, it's a very simple editing program. But when I set up the file, if you go over to File and then Document Settings, you'll see that I chose 720p. I recorded this, you'll remember, in 1080p, but I'm editing in 720. And what that means is that the frame, the visible frame is only 720 pixels high, but the camera has 1080 pixels high. So there's a lot of extra outside at the 100% zoom of that frame. So what you'll do is you'll look along here, follow the waveforms, and clip there, and then get to the point, clip there, where I start talking again, and you'll just pull these guys over, and now essentially what you've got is a jump cut. So what you'll do next is to take one side of that jump cut, and you'll see that it's a solid line when you're looking directly at the clip there. So, and you can move it around. You just have to move it by 30%. So, you know, right now my head's in the middle of the screen. If I take this and shove it over here, that's about a 30% difference. Or I could shove it over here. That's about a 30% difference. Or I could change the scale. Just hold down shift. That's probably about a 30% difference. Just kind of choose a spot there. And then when you shift from this to that, there's a 30% change and you no longer have a jump cut. The other thing you can do is move the camera around or zoom it while you're filming. Of course, this is a lot harder, especially if you're working alone and you just need to remove an awkward pause. But it is kind of the more traditional way that filmmakers work to avoid jump cuts, not in the editing, but in the filming. To recap, if you could pull it off, you can use jump cuts artistically. Otherwise, record a larger picture and edit a little smaller and show different parts of the screen during your edit. Or move the camera while recording. But the one thing I really don't like is when people use little small transitions where they merge the frames together, say to remove like an or something like that. That's it. Your videos can be at least 30% better if you follow the 30% rule. Let me know how it goes in the comments section down below. If you're interested in making your videos more professional, head over to my website and join my mailing list. I've got a great free gift for you just for joining the list. If you're using YouTube to attract new clients, build a community, or promote a product, then Subscriber Nation is for you. Head on over and join the list now, and I will see you over at the website.